We continue now at the top of Daf Samach Tesam and Bezim Maseches Erevin. This is Erevin Daf 69b. Rav Huna had said that if someone is Mechal Shabbos Befarhesia, so then he's considered a mumur for Kalat or a Kula. Once he's a mumur for that particular Avera, it means that we can assume that he violates the entire Torah. So the Gemara had asked, who does he follow? He can't follow Rabbi Meir. And then the Gemara said he can't follow the Rabbanan either. I had to have a mumur lavodas kochavim, because the Rabbanan's opinion is that you're only considered a mumur for Kala Torah Kula if you're a mumur for Avodah Zarah. If it's known that you worship Avodah Zarah, so then it's assumed that you don't keep any of the other Torah. And again, according to Rabbi Meir, it was any Avera. If you're a mumur for any Avera, you'd be a mumur for Kala Torah Kula. So what is this opinion of Rav Huna that it specifically refers to, someone who's a mumur, l'chalo Shabbos b'farhesia? So the Gemara answers, Amar Rav Nachman Bar Yitzchak, Litein Rishos, Ulevatel Rishos. Rav Nachman Bar Yitzchak answers that Rav Huna was talking about our very halacha. He's saying that if you're Mechal Shabbos Befarhesia, it's at that point that you're considered like a non-Jew in terms of the issue of being Mevatel, the Rishos that you have in the Chatzar. Let's say you forget to join the Erev. So if you're Mechal Shabbos Befarhesia, you're considered a non-Jew, and you're no longer able to do this bittel or to accept this bittel from somebody else. Uchidatanya, as we learned in a Braisa, Yisrael Mumur Meshamer Shabbat B'shuk. If you have a Yisrael who keeps Shabbos in the marketplace, meaning he doesn't violate Shabbos in public, he can be Mevatel Rishus. However, if you have a Mumur who he doesn't even keep it in the marketplace, even Befarhesia violates Shabbos, Eino Mevatel Rishus. He's not allowed to be Mevatel his Rishus, Mipnei Sha'amr, because they said Yisrael, when it comes to a Jew, Notel Rishus V'nosin Rishus. He's allowed to take Rishus and he's allowed to give his Rishus up. Uvenachri, but when it comes to a Nachri, you have to rent from him the Rishus. The laws of Bittel Rishus don't apply to a non-Jew. Ketzad, how so? Omer lo Rishusi kenuyalach, Rishusi mevutelis lach. If a Yisrael says, I'm giving up my Rishus, kana, then it works. Ve'ein tzarech lezakos, you don't need to have any formal kinyan. And again, that only, you don't need to use a kinyan sudr. That only works for Yisrael, does not work for Nachri. That's what Rav Huna was talking about. That is Rav Nachman Bar Yitzchak's answer on behalf of Rav Huna. Rav Ashi gives a different answer for Rav Huna. He says there is a Tana who holds that Shabbos is just like Avodah Zarah, just like if you're a Mumur according to the Rabbanan, just like if you're a Mumur L'Avodas Kochavim, you're a Mumur for Kala Torah Kula, so too this particular Tana that we're about to quote in the Braisa holds the same thing is true if you're a Mumur L'Chal L'Shabbos B'Farhesia. Ketanya, as we learned in a Braisa Mikem, it's talking here about bringing Karbanos. It says, from among you we accept Karbanos. So v'lo kulchem, not everyone, not all Jews can bring karbanos, prat l'mumur, so that excludes a mumur. We're going to talk about exactly what kind of mumur. And then it says, mikem bochem chilakti v'lo ba'umos. This distinction that some Jews cannot bring karbanos only applies to the Jewish people. But for the nations of the world, for the non-Jews, any non-Jew can bring a karban, that's totally fine. Rashi over here quotes, l'rabo says, anochrim shenodrim nedarim unedavos ki Yisrael, a non-Jew can bring a karban as a neder or a nedava just like a Jew. And then it says in the pasuk, min ha-behema, you bring a carbon from the animals, lahavi b'nei adam ha-domin l'behema. So here the Braisa says, even people who are similar to animals can bring karbanos. Mikan amru, from here we learn, mikavlan karbanos miposhe Yisrael. You're allowed to accept karbanos from the negligent ones of Israel, from the sinners of Israel. Kadesh yachzer b'tshuva, this is a way to allow them to do teshuva. So this seems to be a bit of a contradiction. We said before that a mummer is not allowed to bring a karban. Here we're saying a poshe Yisrael is allowed to bring a karban. The Gemara will ask that. And then it says at the end of the braisa, chutz min hamummer v'hamenasech yayin, except a mummer and somebody who pours wine to Avodah Zarah, worships Avodah Zarah, and somebody who's Mechal Shabbos Befarhesia. So here it seems to be saying again, repeating itself, that a mummer is not allowed to bring a carbon. So the Gemara asks, Haguf Akasha, this Bryce is internally contradictory. Amrit mikem velo kulchem lehotzias amummer. First you exclude the mummer. V'hadr tani mekablen karbonos miposhe Yisrael. Then we say we accept karbonos from poshe Yisrael. So the Gemara answers for that, Holo Kasha, that's not difficult. Reisha b'mumur l'chola Torah Kula. The Reisha is talking about someone who's a mumur known to violate the entire Torah. Mitziyasa b'mumur l'davar echad. The middle part of the Braisa, where we're accepting from a Poshe Yisrael, is talking about somebody who was just mumur for one particular Isser, but not for the entire Torah. But then the Gemara says, what about the Seifa? Ema Seifa, chutz min ha-mumur v'amenasech yayin. It excludes mumur once again. So hi mumur hechidami. What's the case at the end of the Braisa? E mumur l'chola Torah, if we're saying that a mumur for Kala Torah Kula can't bring a carbon, high new ratio. It's exactly what we said in the ratio. Ila Davar Echad, if he's just a mummer for Davar Echad, that person could bring a carbon. Kasha Mitziyasa. That would be difficult from the middle of the Braisa where he said he's allowed to bring a carbon. So what is the Seifa talking about? El Alav Hachikama. Rather, is it not? Here's what the Seifa means. Chutzmin Hamummer Lenasech Ulechalel Shabbosus Befarhesia. It means a mummer for Avodah Zarah or a mummer who's Mechal Shabbos Befarhesia, they're considered like a mummer for Kol HaTorah Kula. They also cannot bring a carbon. Alma, you see from this, Avodah Zarah Veshabbos Ki Hadodi Ninu, you see that the Braisa is telling you that Avodah Zarah and Shabbos are the same thing in this regard. Shma Mina, you see that this is a Tana that holds like that, and that's what Rav Huna was saying as well. We continue now with the Mishnah. Anshei Chatzar Sheshakach Echon Mehen Velo Iriv. Let's say you have somebody from a Chatzar. We've quoted this Mishnah now many times already. An individual from a Chatzar forgets to join the Erev. Beso Asr Milahachnis Umilahotzi Lo Vilohem. From his house, he's going to be Mevatel, his Rishos in the Chatzar, fine, so they can all carry in the Chatzar. But from his house, you can't bring in, you can't bring out, and that's also for everybody, for him and for the other people. They cannot bring things in and out of his house. Vishalohem, but when it comes to their house, Mutarin Lo Vilohem. Everybody can bring things in and out of their houses. Even he can do it, they can do it, no problem. Nasnu lo rishusan. Now let's say you have the reverse. Let's say they all give up their rishus to him. So everyone's being mevatel rishus to this one guy who didn't join the Erev. So hu mutter v'hein asurin. It turns out then that he is mutter to take from his house to the chatzar. Rashi says, hu mutter lahotzi mibeso lechatzar. He can carry from his house to the chatzar. V'hein asurin afilu mibeso lechatzar. They cannot carry at all, even from his own house. V'alfa gav de rishus achasin. Now that's a little strange, even though that should all be one rishus. With a gemar mefarish time, and the gemar is going to explain why this case is worse. Why, when they're all mevatel rishus to him, he's the only one that can carry. They cannot even carry from his own house. The Gemara will address that. In any case, that's what happens. In that case, hayu shnayim. Now, what if they're mevatel the rishus to two people? So they all give up their rishus in the chatzar, but it was two people who forgot to join the Erev, Osrin Zalza. So then they asked her one to the other. It's not going to work because, very nice, you were all mevatel your rishus to two people, but those two people haven't made an Erev. So they asked her one to the other, so you still have a problem. She'echad nosein rishus v'notel rishus. One person can give up his rishus and can accept rishus, but shnayim, when it comes to two people, nosin rishus, they can give up their rishus in a chatzar, v'yein notlin rishus, but two people cannot accept rishus because when they do so, they still aser one to the other. And now the Mishnah finishes off. Me'ei masai nosin rishus. When does a person able to give up his rishus in the chatzar? Be'shamay omer be'shamay semi ba'od yom. He's got to do it before Shabbos. Uve'silol omer mishach hashecha. But be'silol say a person can give up his rishus in the chatzar even after Shabbos begins. Misha nosan rishuso v'hotzi. Now let's say somebody does give up his rishus in the chatzar, but then he starts carrying out into the chatzar. Bein v'shogeg bein v'mezid. Whether he does so by mistake, whether he does so on purpose, hareza oser, he is going to reclaim his rishus in the chatzar, and he's going to forbid everyone else from carrying. Divrei Rabbi Meir, that's Rabbi Meir's opinion. Again, this was quoted multiple times on the previous Amudim. Rabbi Yehuda Omer, Rabbi Yehuda says, "B'mezid oser." If he does it on purpose, he reclaims his rishus in the chatzar. Then he does, in fact, aser. B'shogeg eino oser. But if he does it by mistake, then he doesn't get back his rishus in the chatzar, and he does not aser on the other people in the chatzar. So the Gemara now says, "Beis ohu de'aser." So the individual who gives up his rishus in the chatzar, his house is still a problem. In other words, nobody can carry from his house into the chatzar. He still has rishus in his house. Hachatzero sharia, but apparently, let's say he had a certain area of the chatzar, that would all be, he's given that up, that you can carry in that area. Hechidami, what exactly is the case? Idabatil beso amayasr. If he totally gave up his rishus, why is his house still a problem? Idalobatil, if he didn't totally give up his rishus, chatzero amayasharia, his area of the chatzar should also be a problem. So the Gemara answers very simply, Hachav am I asking, and here what is the case? Kagon Shabitol Rishus Chatzer, Velobitol Rishus Beso. He gave up his Rishus in the Chatzer, but he did not give up his Rishus in his house. Because Savri Rabbanan, the Rabbanan hold, Hamavatol Rishus Chatzer, when someone gives up the Rishus in his Chatzer, Rishus Beso Lobitol. He does not necessarily give up the Rishus in his house, and that's why it's a problem to carry from his house to the Chatzer. Chatzer is totally okay, his house is a problem. Why? The Dayarinish Bebayis below Chatzer. It's normal for a person to live in a house and not have a chatzar. That's a normal situation, so he gave up his rights in the chatzar, but he did not give up his rights in the house. V'shelohen mutter lo v'lohen. Then it said that their houses are totally mutter even for him. Why are their houses okay for him to carry from their houses to the chatzar and vice versa? My time, what's the reason? Dehavi oreach legabayu. He's considered to be a guest in their house. A guest is allowed to carry from their house to the chatzar, so to him, he's also considered a guest no worse than that. Nasnu lo reshusan. Now let's say the reverse. Let's say they give up their reshus in the chatzar to him, who mutter v'hein asurin. So then he gets to carry and they don't. So the Gemara asks, v'nehavi inu legabe ki orchin. Why can't they be his guests and they should at least be able to carry from his house to the chatzar? So the Gemara answers, chad legabe chamisha have orech. One guy can be a guest by five people. Chamisha legabe chad lo have orech. But five people cannot be a guest by one person. And the Gemara now says, well, shma minam mevadlin v'chozrin mevadlin. Does the Mishnah mean to teach us that this is all happening on the same Shabbos? He first gives up his rights, and then they give up their rights on the very same Shabbos. You can go back and forth, so I can give up my rights, then get back, so one can give to the other, and all on the same Shabbos. Gemara says, no, that's not what the Mishnah means. Hachi kamar, what the Mishnah means is as follows. Nasnu lo rishusan me'ikara. New case. Let's say they gave up their rishus from the beginning of Shabbos, then he can carry. But no, he can't give up his rishus. You don't necessarily say that he can give up his rishus, and then mid-Shabbos, he gets back the rishus from them. That's not true. If they do it meikar, if they give up their rishus, hu mutter v'hein asur, and then he is mutter, and they are asur. Hayushnayim osrin zalzeh, then it said if two of them are left, so in other words, two people didn't join the Erev, and everyone's mevatel to them, it's still a problem, because they asur one to the other. Gemara says, pshita, isn't that obvious? Of course they asur each other. Gemara says, lo tzricha, no, it's needed. Dohadr chan minayu uvatale l'chavre. Now one of the ones who is remaining, these last two people, one is mevatel to the other. So maybe that should work. Ma'u detem olishri, what might you have thought that should work? Kamash mola, no, it does not work. Kevin devina debata lohavale sharyusa by chotzer. At the time that he's being mevatel, he has no permission in the chotzer, so it's not going to work. Rashi explains why it doesn't work. Kamash malon de lo dami. De ilu hasam kol chad v'chad mevatel reshusei. In a normal case, everyone's being mevatel his own reshus. That's fine. Aval hacha, but over here, kevin de shar b'nei chotzer lav lahay defayish l'chudei batli el tarvayu. Remember what happened was, everyone in the chotzer was mevatel their own reshus to both of these people. So now this guy who's being mevatel to the other guy, the last two remaining, he's not only being mevatel his own reshus, he's being mevatel the reshus that everyone gave to them. Ki hadr chadu mevatel li'idach reshus adidei, when this guy tries to then be mevatel to the last remaining guy, so matzi levetule reshusa da'akni lechavre lo matzi levetule. So that part, which is his own, fine, but he can't give up the other stuff. When they all gave up their rishus and the chotzer to him, it didn't allow him to carry. Because they had asked each other. That first bittel that the first residents did nothing. So now when this guy's trying to be mevatel, he can't give up their rishus. He can give up his own rishus, but their rishus, it was a bad bittel. To halo kanya, never really worked. So their original bittel never really worked. So he can't go ahead and on the shoulders of that bittel say, I'm going to be mevatel to this individual. That's not going to work in that situation. Now the Gemara continues, and the Gemara says, she'echad nosin rishus. Again, the Mishnah made a statement and said that one person can give rishus and can also take rishus, but two people, they can give rishus, but they cannot take. So the Gemara says, asu lamali, what do you need to repeat this idea about one person? We've already established that one person can give and take rishus. Inosin tanin, inotel tanin. It's already said that that one person can give up the rishus and one person can take the rishus. So the Gemara says, you're right, sefer tzrichle. That little phrase is not necessarily, but it's not necessary, but what it goes on to say is the chiddush by two people. Shnayim nosin rishus. Two people can give up rishus. Gemara says, honami pshita. That phrase is also obvious. So the Gemara says, no, mahu detema, what might you have said? And we will continue with this discussion in the next video on Daf Ayin Omer Aleph.